there isn't anyone here that has not experienced an Acts 2:4 experience in your life, please come up here tonight. You need the baptism of the Holy Spirit in your life. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Praise the Lord. It'll change your life forever. Look, some people are not unpackaging the gift they've received. There's an initial baptism of the Spirit when you begin to speak in tongues. The initial baptism, it comes upon you and you begin to speak in tongues. And then many people, what they do, they stop there. And they don't unpackage the gift that's been given to them. And I'm telling you, if you receive the baptism of the Holy Spirit and you spoke in tongues, you need to continue to pray in the Holy Ghost. And it will take you places in the realm of the Spirit. Hallelujah. The Holy Ghost will show you things to come. Hallelujah. And you'll be able to see devils in people's eyes when you're walking down the street. And that snake is coming at your door, hallelujah, trying to steal from you. Hallelujah. We've got to have the gifts of the Spirit of God. Hallelujah. Get filled up with the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He wants to be a part of us. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now, every night I've been preaching on this series about the divine inheritance, and I named off 8 things. It's already 8 o'clock here, but I'm going to just go on with this message, because every night, even though I haven't finished these messages, they've always ended at the right time. Just go by faith. I'm not in control here. Hey, if you come here to look at me, you're looking at the wrong person. Because I don't have anything for you. You have to look beyond this man and the one who sent me. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I am like Jesus. I can do nothing without him. Oh, hallelujah. Glory to God. I am subject to him. I like the wind. If he carries me somewhere in a message or wherever I gotta go, that's where I gotta go. Amen. That's called yielding to the Holy Ghost. Allowing him to have control of your life. Hallelujah. It's a great pleasure to know him. You can know the Holy Spirit. He is a person. The day I met the Holy Ghost, let me share this with you. It's coming to my mind. I was doing some deep study on the Holy Spirit. I've been baptized in the Holy Ghost. But I begin to read and realize that he's a person.
But
one day, I felt led to go into my room. Then I fell to my knees.
And
then suddenly what happened was such a powerful presence came into that room.
Man,
I can't explain it to you. But I said, who are you? And he said, I am the Holy Spirit. And the presence of God was, it was so, I was in not fear like a horror movie, but fear and reverence of God. And it was my introduction to the person of the Holy Spirit. And I began to yield my life to him. All these things that took place, seeing Jesus, being caught up into heaven, experiencing the person, the Holy Ghost. My life was changing rapidly. See, let me tell you something. When you get filled with the Holy Ghost and you start moving with him and you get into the scriptures, you can have such exponential growth. I'm telling you, I talked to people that were in the church for 30 years. And just like they said to Jesus, where does this man getting this wisdom from? I was getting it from the Holy Ghost. And in the Spirit, there's no limits. Take the limits off God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Take your limits off God. There's no limits with God. And I begin to grow rapidly. And I surpassed a lot of people in church who were just wondering what was happening, but I was simply yielding my life to the Holy Ghost. And the same thing will be with you. Don't be in dismay. But don't be in dismay, because you don't need to know all of this. All you need to know is what the Holy Spirit wants to teach you. Become a master of that. One word of wisdom from God, my friend, will carry you throughout your whole life. He's called the Spirit of Truth. He's called the Spirit of Grace. And we must not insult the Spirit of Grace that dwells within us. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Amen.
Amen.
So invite the Holy Spirit to come. Don't be afraid. Many people are afraid. The Holy Spirit's our friend. He's a friend. He wants your fellowship. Don't be afraid of God.